All right, Chad Morris, enjoy your fall in Fayetteville. It's never going to get easier than this. Mark Rogers TV, the voice of college football, breaking down all the schedules in the Power 5, plus the major independents and ranking them 70 all the way up to number 1. Arkansas is next on our list at number 27 in the nation, number 6 in the SEC. So it's a difficult schedule for the obvious reason that Arkansas plays in the most difficult division in college football in the SEC Western Division. They also are right now, by far, no question, the worst team in the division, so they've got to play everyone better than them. The SEC Eastern Division is a solid division, very good, not close to the West at this point, but who does Arkansas have to play in the East? That is key, of course. Well, they play Vanderbilt, and they play Missouri. Arkansas, of course, is lined up and scheduled to take on Mizzou each and every year as part of that rivalry system in the SEC. And so Arkansas goes to Missouri the last day of the season, November 24th, which typically turns into a Friday game after Thanksgiving. Arkansas's other game, as we mentioned, is against Vandy, the worst team in the SEC, certainly in the Eastern Division. So they get the lightest touch almost possible in terms of SEC scheduling, even though they've got to deal with the likes of Alabama and Auburn and the rest of them. Out of conference, this was the season in which Arkansas was scheduled to play Michigan. They had signed a series to play home and home against Michigan, but that one was canceled by Michigan. So, Arkansas, I'm knocking your schedule, but it's not your fault. Michigan canceled. So, what the Hogs are left with is a pretty bad non-conference schedule that includes no Power Fives. And when I say pretty bad, what I really mean is awful. It's one of the worst non-conference schedules in college football. And for a team that's struggling, that has to face the SEC Western Division, this is basically what Chad Morris needs to get his young players reps and to get his team some confidence in possibly winning some football games. And if things break right in the SEC, if they can win two games in the SEC, and with Mizzou and Vandy as the designated teams out of the SEC East, Arkansas has a chance to win six games because they're going to go 4-0. They should go 4-0 in non-conference play and get to a bowl game. That's for a later date in regards to my preview and prediction. Eastern Illinois at Colorado State, North Texas, and then later in the year against Tulsa. No Power Fives, no real group of five powers to play. Eastern Illinois is one of the worst teams in the country. At Colorado State, they are a bottom 30 team in the FBS. North Texas is decent. They played well again, but it's a group of five, and it's not one of the elite group of five teams. And then later against Tulsa, a team that went 2-10 last year, that went 10-3 2 years ago. So we'll see what Tulsa has this season for Arkansas, a game on October 20th. So for the Hogs, the most difficult stretch is right out of the gate in the SEC on September 22nd when they make a trip to the Plains and the Auburn Tigers. They follow that up with their neutral site game against Texas A&M on September 29th, and then they play the Alabama Crimson Tide on October 6th. Auburn, Texas A&M, and Alabama consecutive weeks, and even throw in Ole Miss the next week at home for the Hogs. It's the 27th. Most difficult schedule out of 70 teams in the Power 5 plus the major independents, and it's because of the SEC Western Division. Otherwise, Arkansas, with an easy slate, it will never get any easier, Chad Morris, than Eastern Illinois, Colorado State, North Texas, and Tulsa, and then Vandy and Mizzou out of the East. It sets up for a possible run to a postseason game with six wins for Arkansas. Please stay tuned for the rest of our schedule rankings. When we conclude our series on the schedules, we'll move on to our previews and predictions right here at Mark Rogers TV, the voice of college football.